Disturbing the game.
Okay. I'll let you know when we're there.
I don't want to lose something by accident. I mean, yeah, we got a little sediment stuff on the bottom, but it ain't bad. That's not the separation,
no, it's just,
that's just a different joint.
The next joint back, I think.
There it is. Okay. So we're going to pause it here. Okay. So that's that.
See it, or you want me to just tell you?
I can see it. Anything pops up. So that's even like,
kind of,
yeah, the opposite way. And then here we go. This is where we start getting, that's why we're getting the back pitch, because that pipe, that one, is lipped this way over it. And so now it's aimed like this. And now we're getting the back pitch. So we'll find that. Jetting from the manhole, pulling back, it pulls the water out. That's how I could see before.
Oh.
Really good. That would, manhole would not. But
I see
if they dug it back up and exposed it, and had it cut, and then it all would drain out, right? Or we could pull it all out from the camera from the, you know, the exposed hole.
Yeah.
And then they can determine what they wanted to do. But really, this line is the whole thing is shit.
Yeah.
Never works good when you fix one spot and then you patch in another spot. At that point, you know the whole line's shit, so you probably should have
just replaced it all.
You should have just, yeah, went back. Went from here and just dug this whole fucking thing and just put one whole straight pipe in there.
So you don't think if you took a 6-inch guzzy hose and set it right there on the top and taped it? No?
No. Okay. I wish. People all think that it works. No, because it's vented back that way, so you start getting suction from there and you would get some stuff. The only way you get the water out with the back hose is if I had it sitting down in it and I'm pulling the water to it. I wish it would work that way, but we get a lot of people fucking wood ticks.
God damn it!
I know.
We're
I had a feeling.
Right in the fucking.
I know. I had a feeling we were getting wood ticks over here. They were really bad this year.
Yeah, I found a couple on me when I took my kids camping a couple weekends ago.
Gotcha. I got a lot in my yard too.
It wasn't even hot yet.
Fucking, then my dogs and my cats keep getting them on them, and then they
bring them in the house.
Yeah. I wasn't even outside. It was in the morning one day this week, and I went to go, I just let the dog out to the bathroom. Oh, I brought the garbage can down real quick. I just walked my driveway. My stupid dog and my stupid cats followed me out there, and they ran down in the ditch across where I put the garbage can, right? Go back in the house. They weren't even out there that long. They just went down in the ditch and they came back and yelled at them. And they followed me back in. And then the dog was chasing the cat onto the couch when I was trying to drink coffee before I left. And also, what the fuck? There was one crawling on my leg. And I was like, where'd that come from? Oh, probably from the dog or the cat that just jumped on me. Three. I found three before I left.
Yeah.
One was crawling on the couch. And then there was another one. All of a sudden I was like, what the fuck? It was on my neck.
Yeah, I was doing road construction. Let's see, last summer, when you're done with drums, you just slide them off on the side of the road. Well, that's where wood ticks like to hang out because it's tall grass and shit.
Yep.
Well, it was about this time of year, and I had to pick up drums. It must have been 20 drums that I picked up, and they were all just covered in fucking wood ticks. I was like, Jesus Christ. I ended up getting permethrin for all my clothes.
Yeah,
I
know.
That works.
I ordered
really
some,
well.
And it hasn't come yet.
I got an extra bottle, I think. I ended up getting two big bottles. It was like some deal on Amazon, and I think I've gone through like an eighth of a bottle because shit's
8 wood 6.
I need to spray my tent down with it.
Yeah.
I need to do it because.
Hopefully you don't wreck like the waterproof part.
No, it said it's safe for that kind of stuff.
Oh, okay. See, and then it's back pitched here too. So we make a drop. I'm gonna locate this.
That's gonna be in the creek.
I don't think it's really 20 feet. Honestly, I don't think they should have fucking dropped it. I think they dropped it because. I beat the path down a little bit when I was here. Otherwise it was, this grass was everywhere. I was like,
yeah.
Fuck this. I don't think so, because I just gotta go to Alex and see what he wants to do. Because we jetted this and got it clean, but that's not the problem. The problem is that there's a separation in one spot, and we got a huge back pitch problem here.
Yeah.
And water's just always going to settle here. And I already know about the other part of the pipe, and they have a recording of that. We know that the cast iron is really rusty.
Yeah.
And she said it too. She said the other guy that was here said that. Well, that she watched it too.
Yeah.
She said there was like rust pieces just. Stuff like pieces hanging off the top of the pipe, and I was like, yeah, I remember that pipe being really rusty and shitty.
So do you want me to hold off on putting the hose away, or I can probably do that, right?
You can probably do that. It's just